Hi guys, this is Dr. Teo Wan Lin and welcome to my podcast, Dermatologist Talks, Science of Beauty. In today's dermatology flash briefing, we're going to be talking about lip problems that can arise from wearing a face mask. Mask lip is a colloquial term, much like maskne, that has been coined to describe the excessively dry and chapped lips that can arise from prolonged wearing of face masks. Now, in the previous episodes, we've spoken about the unique skin microenvironment that face mask wear creates. Having eczema on the lips is actually a specific condition known as cheilitis. This refers to a defect in the barrier function of the lip mucosa, and it can be aggravated in an occlusive environment, such as under a fabric face mask. The skin on the lips is different from other parts of the body, from the skin on the other parts of the body, because it's a lot thinner. And the constant contact of salivary enzymes also means that the nature of the skin cells is slightly different, as it's able to tolerate the acidity of the digestive enzymes. The triggers for cheilitis would be similar to that of what would aggravate eczema on other parts of the body. So an imbalance of bacteria present on your skin, what we call microbiome dysbiosis, barrier dysfunction due to contact with irritant cleanses, and also the constant friction created by face mask wearing, all that can increase transepidermal water loss, which is water loss via the skin to the environment. Individuals who are predisposed to cheilitis may have a tendency to develop eczema. So this very often boils down to a genetic defect in the production of the protein filaggrin, which is responsible for the production of ceramide, the main fatty lipid that holds skin cells together and protects your skin against the external environment. Having a fabric or a textile in contact with your lips, with sweat and saliva, nasal droplets that accumulate in a high humidity occlusive environment when you're speaking under the face mask, overall, this can cause an imbalance of bacteria and even yeast such as candida, which usually is a normal colonizer. If this overgrows in a humid environment, then you may get rashes that's triggered off by fungal infections. Candidiasis usually does not occur readily in immunocompetent individuals. So unless you have diabetes or other causes of immune suppression, it is less likely for you to develop candidiasis of the skin. However, wearing a face mask sort of creates a new area for these conditions, which usually only occur in the skin folds, for example, what we call the intertriginous regions. It creates a new area for these conditions to develop. Now, internationally, I think that dermatologists have observed more and more patients who develop worsening of skin conditions associated with face mask wearing, but specifically also worsening of cheilitis, which is rashes around the lips. So these rashes can sometimes be confused for perioral dermatitis, or they could be part of a continuum. So you can start with having angular cheilitis, whereby the rashes are localized around the corners of your mouth. Now the corners are particularly susceptible because it's considered a flexural area where there's friction. When you speak, when you eat, there can be more friction over the area, and that's where individuals may notice just cracking of the lips, and it can be very painful. Now, once a crack occurs, secondary skin infections can occur. So this can be due to skin bacteria such as Staphylococcus aureus. So if you have yellow crust developing on your skin, it can be due to candidiasis, which is similar to what some individuals develop over the groin, under the breast area when it's very humid, when the area is not kept dry. I feel that, you know, overall, we are still quite early on in terms of this mask wearing behavior in our COVID-19 pandemic, in our current COVID-19 pandemic. So we certainly expect to see more and more patients with their pre-existing lip keratitis being brought on by wearing of the face mask, and also patients who never had problems with their lips suddenly developing problems. Now, it is important to note that keratitis is a condition of the lips that can occur even in the absence of this phenomenon of mask wearing. Individuals who are predisposed to endogenous eczema, atopy, these individuals have a history of a personal or family history of asthma, allergic rhinitis, a family history of childhood eczema. That is the innate tendency to develop these patches of dry, flaky, sensitive skin over any part of your body. So when it's on the lip, we call it keratitis. Keratitis, when it occurs at the corners of your mouth, is known as angular keratitis, and as we mentioned earlier, can be contributed to by skin infections like yeast infections, candidiasis, and also bacterial infections. People who develop irritation from topically applied ingredients on the lips or on the face, so certain harsh cleansers may not have a drying effect on the facial skin but affect the sensitive areas such as the corners of your lip, the eyelids where the skin is thinner, or if you are wearing lipstick, lip gloss, or even your lip balm and it contains certain ingredients, which may be tolerated well by another individual but you develop sensitivity to that, if you have an allergy to mint, for example, in your toothpaste, if your toothpaste contains SLS, you may be more sensitive to these ingredients if you are an individual that is predisposed to atopy, and in this case will develop keratitis. The toothpaste you use is an important consideration for rashes that occur around the mouth area. So perioral dermatitis is a condition that results in flaky red skin around the mouth area, which also corresponds to the area covered by the face mask, that's also affected by what is applied on the skin. So use of many different skincare products is a significant risk factor for the development of perioral dermatitis, and the toothpaste you use can be a potential sensitizer as well. Another factor I would consider is the element of stress. So stress can worsen eczema in an individual who is predisposed to it. It basically works by suppressing your body's immune system. And as we know, eczema is regarded as a immunogenetic condition. So you first have the genetics which predispose you to the condition, and then your immune system then responds in a way that is slightly abnormal, and that results in the cycle of inflammation. Finally, I want to close with some tips that I have to treat or to prevent the development of lip keratitis, and in this case of the COVID-19 pandemic, what is trending now as mask lip. First of all, give your skin a break from prolonged mask wearing. The use of a biofunctional textile, such as the one I described in my earlier episodes, the Zinco, the Kyon's mask under the biomaterials arm, because of its bactericidal effects to alter the skin microbiome, that can certainly improve the skin's ability to regulate the microenvironment and maintain skin health. Choose light colored or reflective colored masks as opposed to darker colors, because light colors reflect heat. And it's important because you want to keep the skin cool, and this is also to prevent further irritation and accumulation of moisture. So you want to increase the rate of evaporation. A textile that has been treated with a higher evaporation coefficient is going to be more beneficial. Minimize application of too many lip products. Now, lipsticks in the era of COVID-19 and mask wearing is somewhat inconvenient. So I would say traditional, glossy type of lip products or liquid lip products will be very impractical when worn under a face mask. Lip stains, which rely on the pigment kind of settling onto the mucosa and creating the color that you desire, is going to be a little bit more transfer resistant than your traditional smooth glossy sort of lip products. I would definitely avoid any peels or lip scrubs with beads that are actually trying to exfoliate the surface of the lips, which really is quite harsh. And if you do use a lip scrub, the one we use in our patients, formulated by the pharmacy, is one that is based off phytoceramides encapsulated in crystals. So these dissolve onto your skin. They are not physically abrasive. And it's essentially the microcrystalline structure that gives the product its texture of a scrub, as opposed to using beads or other sorts of sandy, abrasive materials, which will definitely aggravate any problems of sensitive lips. Moisturize your lips. So the very basic emollient which you can find in the drugstore is petroleum jelly, Vaseline. Now, that, in my opinion, is perfectly safe, cost-effective. It prevents transepidermal water loss. In order to really repair your lips, in terms of repairing the skin barrier, we would want to look for a formula that actually has ceramide content. Now, application of traditional ceramides, which are found in moisturizers, are impractical on the lips because, first of all, it's it leaves a whitish sort of cast and it's very sticky. So what we use instead are edible phytoceramides derived from plant oils. So shea butter, for example, these have a natural phytoceramide structure that mimics your body's natural lipids that form the skin barrier. Humectants like hyaluronic acid can settle into the dermis, and it plumps up your lips, so it is definitely a good ingredient to look out for. Anti-inflammatory ingredients are increasingly recognized in the formulation of topical moisturizers, both for your body, your facial skin, and definitely for the lips, because the anti-inflammatory components here are botanical, such as grapeseed oil. These actually help to regulate the local immune system, and results in what we call the effect of a prescription emollient device, and that is something which has a steroid-like calming effect but without the side effects of topical steroids, which are skin thinning and skin atrophy. So I feel that overall it's really important for us to recognize wearing a face mask does create a new set of problems for our skin, but importantly, we shouldn't neglect our lips as well. That's it for today's Dermatology Flash Briefing. Thank you guys for joining me, and till the next episode. You can follow me on my Instagram for the latest podcast updates, Dr. Teo Wan Lin, and also visit us on our website at www.scienceofbeauty.net.